Hi everyone, and thank you for joining us for today's Daily Touchpoint. Today we are in Isaiah 42, and I just want us to stay in the first few verses of Isaiah, and I'm going to point out some things that I learned as I was reading and studying this verse. So let me jump in by just reading those opening verses for us. Behold my servant, whom I uphold, my chosen, in whom my soul delights. I have put my spirit upon him. He will bring forth justice to the nations. He will not cry aloud or lift up his voice or make it heard in the street. A bruised reed he will not break, and a faintly burning wick he will not quench. He will faithfully bring forth justice. He will not grow faint or be discouraged till he has established justice in the earth, and the coastlands wait for his law. And I encourage you to go on and read the rest of Isaiah 42, because there's so much good stuff to unpack there. But I wanted to stop there and just talk about those first four verses. First of all, that opening word, behold, behold my servant. If you read with us yesterday's reading, the end in verse 29, it talks about behold idols, or my version says, behold, they are all a delusion. And so now here in verse 42, there's a contrast, and it says, behold my servant. And that's a clue to us that Isaiah 42 in the opening verses is actually talking about what a commentary says is the servant song. There's four servant songs in Isaiah, passages that are describing attributes about this servant or the Messiah that it will be coming in rescuing Israel. And here we see the first one in verse 42. There's others in Isaiah 49 and Isaiah 50 and Isaiah 52, but here's this first one talking about behold my servant. Now behold isn't just like, oh, you glance at it for a second, right? When you behold something, you look at it, you study it, maybe you're even in awe of it. And I think that's the posture that the writer wants us to have as we read about who this servant is. So now this first one, you'll see in the second part of verse 1, it says, I have put my spirit upon him. He will bring forth justice to the nations. I will put my spirit on him. I don't know about you, but I recall spirit to be Jesus's baptism, right? In Matthew verse 3, or chapter 3, verses 13 to 17, it talks about the Spirit of God descending upon Jesus as he is baptized in the Jordan. And a voice calls out and says, behold, this is my son whom I love. I am well pleased with him. I think there's a connection here. Talking about here, this servant, I think in Matthew we see, oh yeah, this servant that Isaiah is talking about, maybe it's Jesus. And this one, the servant song, is kind of talking about how this servant that's going to come to be a rescuer, to be a Messiah, is going to be spirit-filled. And I would encourage you to go on and, like I said, read the rest of Isaiah 42, because it talks more about who this servant is, about what characteristics he will have, but it also talks about Israel and where they're at this time. And I just want to encourage you as you read to think about, yes, there is, you know, there's so much going on in Israel this time, but there's hope for this future spirit-filled servant who's going to come and be a rescuer. And in fact, we know that this servant that Isaiah is talking about is indeed Jesus Christ, because in Matthew chapter 12, it literally takes these verses and quotes them in talking about Jesus when he was with the crowds, and then when he withdrew to be by himself, it quotes Isaiah saying, behold my servant whom I upheld. So I just want to encourage you this morning that the rescuer, Jesus, our servant, is a spirit-filled servant. He embodies the Holy Spirit, and that he brings that hope to us. So will you pray with me? Dear God, we thank you that you sent your servant, your son, Jesus Christ, to us, and that he is spirit-filled. And God, that brings us hope, because we know that nothing that Jesus does is outside of anything that you do. And God, we even know that you have given your Holy Spirit to be with us, to be our guide. And God, we are thankful for that. I hope that anyone watching today would just be encouraged that the gift of the Holy Spirit is from you, God, and that it is a way that we can be connected to you and connected to your Son, your servant, Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name, amen. Thanks, everyone. I hope you have a great rest of your day.